Gina. How you doing, buddy?
All right. Right on time, man.
Thank you, sir.
Hey, Happy New Year.
Thanks. Happy New Year to you as well.
All right.
The house all decorated up a little bit.
Looks good, man. This is your place, huh?
Festive spirit.
Hey, you got a deer sitting right there. Did you see it?
We always have deer in here.
Look at that.
Yeah, there's always...
Oh, they're so friendly, huh?
Yeah, well, you know, we don't chase them away.
No, look at them. They're just like... Do you feed them?
No, but we planted a lot of, right now it looks a little barren. We planted a lot of seeds and we throw compost back there.
Oh,
so they're always in the compost pile.
Just that's like, great.
So like the apple cores
like
and everything,
seeds.
They're just hanging out.
Yeah. I like wildlife,
yeah, and the kids
man.
Love them.
I just love looking at it.
Yeah, well, there's
there,
a lot of place for wildlife here. We're actually going to fill that in with trees and shrubs because we just had a lot of work, down here. We changed the driveway here because the driveway used to come straight in.
I see.
Now they're going to, they're proposing to do the exits right across the street from us. So we just moved the driveway. So the exit for Surfside Crossing would literally be right across the street. So we had to move everything.
Right.
So we'll
now,
pull this in.
First thing I'm going to say is you're only doing this for NIMBY, right? The only kid. It's not in my backyard. It really is in your backyard.
It really is in my backyard. It's right there. I mean, it's in my backyard so much that you can see my well right out. You see my well right there?
Yeah.
Well, they're saying that they want to cut into the sewer right in front of our driveway. So literally right in front of our driveway, they're going to dig down and they're going to turn off the main sewer. They're going to cut it. And all the sewage that's in that line is going to fall right into this hole 15, 20 feet from our well. So they're really,
you have a well.
Right there.
You don't have town water.
No, right from where they're going to cut in. So they're going to dig a big hole and let all that human sewage, they want to drain this right into pretty much my well. So you can say, it's in my backyard, but they're really going to be affecting my quality of life. Especially, so last night at the ZBA meeting, Feely and Posner were saying that it's now going to take 2.5 years for the infrastructure work. So again, not only are they attempting to contaminate my well, potentially, I'm sorry, I shouldn't even say that, but I mean, I'm sure they're going to change that. It's got to be changed, obviously, but they take no consideration into the neighborhood. And also, if you clear cut this whole area, imagine this whole area, 13 acres, just entirely clear cut.
Yeah, that's a lot of space.
The drainage issues alone.
Is there a way in there or no?
No,
I can't drive in.
No, just
we'll drive along in a little bit.
Yeah, exactly.
Where are you guys at? I mean, what's going on with you? You're the tipping point.
Right.
You guys are part of the tipping point.
You know what? So I'm not here necessarily representing Tipping Point because that is more of a group. So Tipping Point really, I believe, should be more aimed at focusing on, just stopping the project, and that's just another entity altogether. So I'm just more representing myself here. But what's going on now is we're still
going down here because this is part of it, right?
This is the edge of it. You can see the abutters.
Oh, these are the abutters on the left.
These are the abutters. No, the abutters on the right.
Oh, okay. So there's people here. Okay.
Yep. So this was bought by the land bank, this strip of land. And then on the other side of the strip of land is the Sherman Commons.
Okay.
And you can see up here, there'll be cut throughs and everything, just walkways just from where but on the land bank property, there's a lot of cut throughs and traffic up there.
All right.
You can see, we have the solar panels over there. I mean, this is a nice, it's all wooded lots. No one has cut anything down.
Yeah.
The Merediths here have horses right up here on our right. So, I mean, it's not... Yeah, it is in my backyard, but this is my backyard from growing up as a kid. And this is like such a great neighborhood. It's such a great community. It's such great community.
What would you like to see happen there?
Well, it's going
to
be...
You might have to wear your seatbelt.
Yeah, it's going
to
be developed. I mean, they own the land.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's pretty naive to believe that, nothing's going to happen. So, what I would like to see is some sort of... low-income housing development or some sort of a agreement. I think that I know this is probably just you guys are saying this is NIMBY. Now this kind of goes into Jacques and Jones' houses. Yeah. Okay. So this is the back of the property up there. You can see all the trees. Like this is it. And
beautiful.
I mean they're clear cutting. It's
look
beautiful, right? It's beautiful.
Wow.
I've
never been down here either.
Yeah, it's great. And so this is all a unique area of the island. You know what I mean? And you may say it's kind of it's quirky. It's quirky and cool. Whatever though.
It is.
Our Nantucket. You know what I mean? It's our Nantucket. And they have little the Tugley Farms here where my cousin comes here in the summertime. My cousin's Down syndrome, and so they do a lot of events, over at the big house as well for Wero Wero. So they do a lot of great things for the community here. So
I see a sign there. Do you know what that
that's right.
Do you know that sign right
hey,
there?
They're great neighbors. Like I said, they're great neighbors.
You know? All right, so right what now, would you like to see? We're getting.
I would like to see a smaller, low-income housing development. Maybe.
Have you talked to them? Have you said, look,
you know,
could
what?
You guys just do this and
they're
and
really committed
still make
to
money?
The current project.
And
they're really committed to the current project. But you know, I think the armor's starting to crack. I mean, the armor's starting to crack. Last night, there was a few different times, a few different occasions where you could see it in Posner's attitude. I mean, that's the first time he said, you know, something we could mutually agree upon.
Okay.
You know, where before he was always up there, you know, on his dais, you know, preaching that he was going to get it done. So this is the first time he'd ever said, like, there's going to be some sort of, you know, back and forth on this.
Okay.
So this is the first time that, you know, he even mentioned anything about mutually agreeing.
Well, that's
on
a positive.
Anything. That is a positive. Well, I mean, at least he knows that he's, you know.
Do you guys know exactly, have you approached him and said, if you could do it this way, we'll show you exactly what we want. And then he says, well, this is what we want. And then you come up with a compromise.
We haven't gotten that. I mean, he's really committed to it. You know, for instance, the condos. You know, the condos just can't happen. I mean, for the condos. So now we're going to have this condo development in there, which is just going to be a nightmare. It's just, I know that they, you know, in the Enquirer and Mirror, they've been, you know, they were talking it up. But, you know, I don't think the Enquirer and Mirror has really been unbiased in their reporting at all about Feely and Posner.
No.
Or about this project at all.
Okay.
I mean, I can tell you about the first article when we started these meetings at the first town meeting when we went to the Board of Selectmen, and the Enquirer and Mirror said the Selectmen had to endure 30 minutes of comments by locals opposing the project. I mean, it's like, yeah, they
yeah,
had
that
to
was
endure
the word.
Those tough cookies.
Yeah, right.
Those guys had to, they did it.
Isn't
they did it?
It.
They,
yeah.
Are, they,
yeah.
They did it.
Yeah, and the payday is going to be awesome because they endured it.
And, there's just a lot of other, you know, just inconsistencies. They're not really reporting about what's been going on down the street. For example, there's a lot of problems with the ZBA at Posner and Feely's other 40B. And now I know you can't link them together in a trial, you know, now that we're trying to fight this. But, you know, it's still Feely and Posner that had the problems down the street with the ZBA. And so what happened now is that people who bought full market price houses with cottages now are finding out that they're not their cottages. They belong to the, you know, the 40B occupant, that property does. So now, what's going to happen when these lawsuits come in or these people start fighting, you know, Posner and Feely to keep their cottage or garage? Like, the town, I mean, the Enquirer Mirror isn't even reporting it. They're just, you know, it's all high praise for Feely and Posner, it seems. And it's really,
kind of
confusing.
Didn't I read something where another town just had the same issue and they were able to beat it?
Well, towns are able to beat these. This isn't a done deal
it
by
is
any
not,
means. No, it is not a done deal.
Because I think people think it is a done
people
deal.
People think it's a done deal because there's a lot of propaganda going on about it. And there's a lot of propaganda by former planning board members, for example, who were just really preaching that there's nothing you can do. Just ask for a 50-foot setback, and that's all you can do. A 50-foot setback, and you're lucky to get that. So, I mean, it's far from a done deal. I mean, there's a...
When are you going to know? When do you find out?
Well, what's going to happen is what is going to happen? The ZBA is going to have to approve some sort of plan. Their hands are tied. They're going to have to approve some sort of plan. If they show in any way that they are biased against this project, it goes up in front of the Housing Appeals Committee, and the original plan will, you know, most likely be going through. So the ZBA has to approve something.
Well, how do you feel the ZBA has been handling it so far? I mean, you've had so many meetings.
You know what? I think
now.
That the ZBA's hands are tied. The ZBA has to listen to a lot of comments. We haven't gotten, I think a lot of the meetings have been unproductive, but I don't believe that is the fault of the ZBA at all. I think we need to get the information from the developer to the ZBA so we can actually talk about it.